Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. We've got a problem right now, and that problem has a name, inflation. Well, the Bank of Canada, or the Federal Reserve if you're from the United States, has decided to increase interest rates to fix the problem. Ever wonder how that even works? How does increasing interest rates have anything to do with curbing inflation? Well, that's what we'll be covering today, so with that said, let's get into it. So let's talk about inflation. Your purchasing power's worst nightmare. We've made a video on the topic before, but this time we want to dial in on how to fix it. For those of you who don't know, inflation is the general increase in the price level of goods, which means that for the same amount of money, you can purchase less now than you were able to before. Now, inflation is a huge problem in many countries around the world, and there's a variety of reasons for it, including, but certainly not limited to, increasing the money supply with stimulus payments due to a global pandemic, supply chain issues, and an increase in demand for products. Housing market, I'm looking at you. No matter how we got here, we've arrived at the point in time with record high levels of inflation, and central banks around the world have decided that enough is enough. It's time to raise interest rates. But how does that help? Well, let's take a look. First, it will help to understand what interest rates are in the first place. Consider this example. Suppose you lend your friend $100 with an agreement that they will pay you back with interest, let's say 6%. This means that when they pay you back, you will claim your principal $100 back as well as 6% interest on your $100 loan. In this case, that'd be $6. Think of this as an incentive to offer your friend the loan. If you weren't getting anything back in return, that is, loaning out $100 with zero interest, then you aren't really receiving any additional value from loaning it out other than the emotional satisfaction of helping out a friend. When offered a 6% interest rate, now all of a sudden you can make money loaning out your principal. Now, yes, there is a risk that your friend declares bankruptcy or moves to Cambodia and all of a sudden you never see your $100 again. And in that scenario, you'd have to weigh out the probability of that event happening versus your friend simply paying you back in the agreed upon timeframe. But I digress. Expected value is a topic for another time. Let us know in the description if you'd like a dedicated video to the topic. As for interest rates, just as you can get paid interest on a loan that you would lend out, you would also pay interest on a loan that you borrow. Consider a credit card, as they are essentially short-term loans. Suppose that you had a balance on a credit card of $600 with an interest rate of 22%. If you don't pay that bill in the agreed upon time frame, you will owe your $600 principal plus an additional $132, bringing your total balance owing to $732. Hopefully that paints an adequate picture of how interest and interest rates work. So this begs the question, how are interest rates and inflation related? Why are central banks increasing interest rates to curb inflation? Well, it has to do with the opportunity cost of spending your money. When you earn your paycheck, you can do one of three things with it: spend it, save it, or invest it. Now, we'll save the topic of investing for a different video, so for simplicity, assume that you only have two choices. You either spend your money or you save it. But why do people save money? Well, essentially, saving money is the act of foregoing current spending to have the ability to spend more in the future. It's essentially a trade-off, and interest rates play a large role in the decision-making of individuals between current and future spending. What I mean is, if interest rates are low, like they have been for the last couple of years, then there isn't much of a point in saving your money, is there? You wouldn't be earning much, if any, interest, so you'd be better off spending the money now than losing the purchasing power over time due to inflation. But that isn't the only effect in play. Low interest rates also mean that if you take out loans, you don't have a high interest rate to repay, which is why so many people racked up additional debts on credit cards, new car financing, and mortgages over the course of the past couple of years. Low interest rates mean that everybody and their mother is spending money left and right, and the economy is thriving. Not bad for a time period plagued with a spike in unemployment, lockdowns, and full of uncertainty. But if low interest rates are so good for an economy, then why are central banks raising the rates this year? Due to a multitude of factors, including but certainly not limited to an increase in demand for goods, because interest rates are so low, supply chain disruptions due to a global pandemic, and increasing the money supply due to quantitative easing and maybe a little bit of lack of self-control on the central bank's part, we are now seeing record high inflation rates. Inflation rates we haven't seen for decades. Well, what needs to happen to slow the climbing inflation? Well, people need to start slowing down their spending. From a supply and demand perspective, the demand curve needs to shift to the left, which will see a drop in prices as we give the supply side some time to recover and catch up. Wonder why the average wait time for a new car is 4 to 6 months? Well, current demand greatly exceeds current supply. Want to know why housing prices are through the roof right now? Well, current demand greatly exceeds current supply. Want to know why gas prices are at an all-time high? Well, you guessed it, current demand greatly exceeds current supply. So what needs to happen is a decrease in demand. Well, if you can only do two things with your money, spend or save, then to decrease demand would be to decrease your spending and thereby increase your saving. So how does raising interest rates do that? Well, if the bank is offering a high interest rate on savings accounts, maybe more people will be incentivized to use them. On the flip side, if mortgages, car loans, and credit cards start charging higher interest rates for people to borrow, then maybe people won't be as interested in acquiring such loans and they will start spending less. Remember that in our simplified economy, spending less is directly tied to saving more. But this begs the question, isn't spending good for the economy? Won't incentivizing people to stop spending so much be bad for the economy? And the short answer is yes, that's exactly right. Raising interest rates will slow the economy, but remember, that's the entire point. We want to decrease demand in the short run to achieve a point of consumption closer to the equilibrium in the future. With a decrease in spending, we will see a decrease in the severity of the shortages we see in many markets today, and begin decreasing or at least slowing inflation, giving firms a chance to catch up on the supply side. Now, there are things that you can do as a consumer to make the most out of these market conditions we're experiencing. So if there's enough demand for a video highlighting these things, then we'll definitely supply it. Hopefully this sheds a light on the concept of raising interest rates to lower or to control inflation. We wanted to take a brief second to thank all of our viewers for the support you've shown the channel over the past year and let you know that it really encourages us to keep producing content that will help you understand economics both in and outside the classroom. If you liked this video and you found it helpful, then let us know by liking the video, subscribing to the channel, and comment what sort of economic topics you'd like to see us cover in the future. Thanks for watching this video, and we'll catch you in the next.